Jutta Kleinschmidt, winner back in 2001. And it wasn't a surprise if many witnessed their first desert nightmares. Stéphane Pitet-Hansel, the 8-time Dakar winner, 6 times on a bike, and for the last 2 years in a car.
We always want to win, but there can only be one winner, and I believe the best man won the race, and we must come back to beat him.
Larger than life movies this January. Uncharted.
The 2007 Dakar. The toughest rally in the world. Live the adventure only on Supersport. Proudly brought to you by Total Quartz Lubricants.
Huge crowds jammed the opening stages of the 2007 Dakar. 500,000 watching the rally pass on day one alone. The Portuguese bike riders put on a real show on the stage two just outside the city of Portimão. There's not a lot of water on Dakar stages, but Ari Vatanen found plenty. The first stage yesterday was a long one for the fans and for some of the competitors, and it had everything that the Dakar could offer. It was an early morning start, pre-dawn for the lowest runners. The Portuguese sun worked hard to burn off the fog which blanketed the stage for the early riders. The organisers had somehow created an African desert stage in the heart of Portugal. Just too much on day one for some of the privateers. Usually you expect to find deep sand in Africa. This year it came from the starting ramp. And once the fog had got into your goggles as well, it was very hard to get rid of. With 150,000 fans jamming the stages, it was a great spectacle. They took home some wonderful memories and probably some dirty clothing as well. Organisers estimate that over 500,000 people watched the rally pass on its first day. The 2CV was originally designed to carry 4 people and a basket of eggs across a field without breaking the eggs. Looks like 50 years on, it's still doing better than some of its modern rivals. Some crews lost up to 4 hours on this 117-kilometer stage, but now at least they're probably ready for the sands of Africa.
Goed, die posten blijven volgen. Nu 300 meter gaan we iets kunnen.
Today's 67 km second stage was just for cars, bikes and quads. With some very narrow mountain roads, it was just too tight for the trucks, who headed straight for the port of Malaga.